Welcome to another Digital Anarchy tutorial. I'm Tor Olson, Software QA over here at Digital Anarchy. And in today's tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at how to initially set up one of the two speech engines that Transcriptive utilizes, that being IBM's Watson. So now that you've activated the plugin, it's a matter of signing up for one of the two speech engines that we utilize, Watson or Speechmatics. In this case, we'll be doing Watson. So if I can actually maximize this window by hitting the tilde key and clicking on Get Started, we have Speechmatics as one option, but also Watson. So I would just click on the tab to open up the credentials menu. And I need to enter in a user ID and a password, but of course we don't have either yet since we haven't set up our account. So the first order of business is that I need to set up an account on IBM's Bluemix, which is the cloud service that utilizes Watson. And I'll just paste in that URL and go ahead and follow it through. So we're going to create a free account. I'm going to be using my coworker's email address since I have already used mine. So I'll just enter in his email address. And go through the rest of the information, filling it out as I go through. I might just fast forward through this. And once we complete all those fields, we'll go ahead and click Create Account. All right, so a verification email has been sent to the web address we were using, in which case we'll be going over to our inbox, refreshing it, and there is our email. We'll go ahead and confirm our IBM account by following the link that they've sent us. It's not showing up the way it seems to be the case here. I'll look at it in print view. Oh, and there I should be able to confirm my account through the link. So this is what the email looks like. You should be able to confirm your account for verification just by clicking on the confirm account button. Success! Aha, I'm able to log in. So now with the username and password I set up earlier, I'll be able to log in by entering in my credential information. Now at this point you might be asking yourself, well, why can't I already just go ahead and log into Watson? And the reason we can't just yet is the way that Watson's payment model works for your transcriptions, it's going to be 2 cents for every minute you want to have transcribed. However, the first 1,000 minutes you ask to have transcribed are completely free, and that renews at the beginning of each month. It's only after you expunge those 1,000 free minutes that it begins charging you 2 cents per minute. Of course, I could go ahead and expunge all of that right now, but before I could do that, I need to enter in my credit card information so that once those 1,000 minutes are expunged, I start getting charged correctly. So if I go back to the Bluemix dashboard, it'll welcome me. This is very nice of them. I'll be able to go through. So the first thing I want to do is make sure that I define the correct region that I'm going to be operating out of. In this case, I'm just going to choose US South because the South is obviously a little bit closer to us than US East. And I'm going to go ahead to manage to set up my billing. So I can enter in my credit card information. Initially, it'll just say that I have a Lite account that's free, but I want to add a credit card. So I'm going to go through that process. This is going to be a company account, so I'll just enter in all the credential information. I'll just skip right through that very quickly. And of course, at the very end, accept the cloud service terms. Click on Next, and our Lite account should be turned into a full service account. So now that my account is a premium account, it's pay-as-you-go, which includes the speech services. If I navigate over to my webmail account, I should receive an email from Bluemix indicating that my cloud account is being set up. And I'm going to have to wait for them to give me the final okay to verify that my payment information is correct. And now in our experience, this can take a while. We've seen times anything from 15 minutes to 24 hours for the account to be set up initially. And it's just a matter of playing the waiting game for your cloud's account to be set up. So we'll probably use the power of movie magic to fast forward in time to the point where our cloud account is active. In the meantime, while I am waiting for that email to come through, I'm going to log in with my own personal account just to show you the rest of the steps for your speech engine setup for Watson. So I would tab back into my speech engine setup menu in Premiere, and I would just type in my user ID. In this case, it'll be Tor at Digital Anarchy, and my password. I want to make sure that I have the correct region selected, at which point I can click on confirm, and we're logged in. We can always tell by the green checkboxes that will show up next to your user ID and password, at which point I can close our speech engine setup dialog. From here, if I wanted to transcribe some footage, I could just take it, bring it into its own sequence. And so from here, I should be able to go into transcribe. I will, if I can expand this, see the information for my account login. It'll show me how many minutes I have logged for the current month. Again, once this reaches 1,000, then we'll start to see this number for our balance due start to increase. But right now, since just this month, I've only transcribed about 19 minutes worth of material, I am not going to be paying anything. It'll show me the sequence name, how long it is. I can also from here choose a number of different languages. These are the ones that are available for Watson specifically. Speechmatics and Watson have their own specific lists of languages that they each support. I can include speaker diarization here if I so choose by clicking on the checkbox. If I know I have a specific number of speakers, I can allot that amount here. I can also identify questions, which will just add question mark punctuation to sentences that seem like they would have a question at the end of them. And once I'm done, I can go ahead and click on continue, which will encode my sequence audio and send it off to Watson for transcription. Typically, the return time for Watson, you can expect to be about a quarter of the time it would take to play back your sequence in real time. So in this case, since we have a 4-minute sequence, it'll take about a minute to get returned to us. So we'll just wait for that to go through. All right, and there we have our transcript returned. Now I have a transcript with each individual word having its own specific set time code, and it's all fully integrated into Premiere. One last thing I'd add is that between Speechmatics and Watson, in our experience, Speechmatics has been much more accurate across a broad spectrum of different kinds of audio. It can be anything that's even very noisy that has background noise or background music. Speechmatics performs much more consistently and is much more accurate. That being said, you can't really beat 1,000 free minutes and a cheaper overall cost for every minute that you have transcribed. But it can be a real-time saver to use Speechmatics just because your cleanup is not going to be as necessary as it would be for Watson. But that's really all there is to setting up Watson initially. If you want to see what kind of transcription can be generated out of your audio, you can always go to digitalanarchy.com, where we have free trials of all of our plugins, including that of Transcriptive. Again, I'm Tor Olson, Software QA over here at Digital Anarchy, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.